Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to convert from char data type to int data type in C++. So I'll be showing you three methods how you can do this. And I'm also having here like three types of char variable. So the first one is a number 9, but it is of char type. And I'm having here alphabet A. And finally, I'm having here a character array, but it has number 1, 2, 3 in it. But here it's also a char data type. So let's see how we can convert this. Okay. So let's get started over here. So first I will convert this one, this number 9 of char type to int data type. So simplest way you can do this is by, you need to first declare a integer variable. So int n be my integer variable, and what you're going to do is int n equal to the variable name, okay, c. C corresponds to this number 9 over here. So c minus, and you need to put 0 within single quotes. 0 within single quotes. That's it. And if you just put c out n, I'm saving it now and I'm executing and running it. So I will be getting 9 in the output, but I am printing n. N is of int type, which means that this c, which has 9 as a character, has been now converted to of type int. Okay, so now how this works, we are just putting c minus 0 within double quotes, but it's converting our character type into int data type. So I will, like, let me explain it really clearly. Okay, so I will just remove all this stuff over here. Just remove this. I will just cut this and just paste it over here. Just save it. And again, if I execute and run it now, I'll be getting 9. But how are we getting this? Okay, it's really simple. Okay, so let me just have a comment over here. So what happens here was over here is that because of this minus operator, this value and this value over here gets converted to its ASCII value and then performs the minus operation. So let's say 0 has, the ASCII value of 0 is 48. And the ASCII value of our variable C, that is 9, C has 9 in it. So ASCII value of 9 is 57. And because of this minus operation in between, we are getting 9 as the output. And let's suppose say that to make it like more understandable to you, I will just put a plus over here. So just save it now and execute and run it. I'll be getting 105 in the output. So I hope like you would have guessed why you're getting 105, because 57, 48. And it's plus operator over here. So instead of minus, just plus. So it will get added up to 105. Simple. So just undo everything. And same thing. We are just storing it in an int n. And we're just printing it. Okay. C out n. And this n will be having our C variable, that is 9, as a int type. Okay. So this makes, I guess this made sense to you. And this is the first method of doing it. Now let's suppose say that we want to convert our A. But the problem with conversion of A is that A can't be converted to A. Like suppose say we are having 9, but 9 can be converted to int type, but A can't be converted to its int type, but it can be converted to its ASCII value. So let's see how we can convert char A to its ASCII value. So it's really simple. Just what you need to do is you need to assign your variable A to the int variable. So CC is having our char A, and we're just assigning it to our int n, and I'm just printing n. So I'm just saving it and I'm executing and running it now. I'll be getting 97, which is the ASCII value of A. And let's suppose say that we are doing that minus 0 thing, okay? Minus 0 thing over here. Let's see what happens. Okay? So I'm getting 49, and I hope you guessed it, because why we are getting 49. The reason is because ASCII value of A, that is CC over here, is 97, and we are doing minus operation. ASCII value of 0 is 48. So we are getting 49 in the output. Okay, so these are some extra things. So simplest way you want to convert a character into its ASCII values, just assign it to a int variable, or you can just typecast it. So this is also, in case you don't want to, you just want to bypass the, like, creating an integer variable, you can just do this. You can just typecast it. Just put int and the variable name CC corresponds to this one. So save it, and you can just compile and run it now. We'll be getting 97, and we aren't using any int variable, okay, over here. So this is the second way, and the final way is for our character array. So for character array, we will be using the inbuilt function stoy and atoy. So let me declare a integer variable, and I'm putting n equal to stoy, just pass the character array variable name. So triple C is the name, and I'm just C out n over here. So execute and run it. So I'm getting 1, 2, 3, which is, but it is of type int, and I hope we don't need any header file. So I'll just remove this. I will run it again as well. So it's working. No need of any header file, and yes toy and yet toy. Okay, so I will save it and run it. So I'm getting 1, 2, 3 again, and I hope this doesn't work for like our single character variable, because it's a character array. Yet toy works, and if I just put C, okay, I'm just putting C. C is our 9, and if I just execute it now, so it doesn't work. It works only for our character array. Okay, so this is the third way of converting our character data type to integer data type in C++, and I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other conversion videos in C++, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check the rest of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.